Look, I don't blame him. Honestly, I don't blame him. I think the press should apologize to me and to him, because the question that comes to him is completely wrong. And because of that, he had that out of control reaction. But I don't blame him at all. I was asked about my passion, and you know, because most of you were in my press conference. I was speaking about myself, and then the question to the Chelsea manager was, like, I told that he behaves like a clown. Probably the journalist wanted to say that, but didn't have the courage to say that. So he told, Mourinho told that you behave as a clown. So I don't blame the Chelsea manager at all, and I understand his reaction. I was speaking about myself, saying that I don't need to behave as a clown to show passion, that I control my emotions in a better way. Everybody knows I don't need the Chelsea manager to say that I made mistakes in the past, and I will make in the future, hopefully. I know that I celebrate goals running 50 meters. I celebrate goals sliding in on my knees. I got celebrations jumping to the crowd. I'm not free of that, especially if we score a winning goal in a specific moment. I'm not free to have a out of control reaction. But what I was trying to say is that I behaved bad a few times, and in this moment I control myself much better. Doesn't mean that my passion is not the same. So, a wrong question, and obviously a strong answer, but I don't blame, you know? The only thing I want to say to end the story is that, yes, I made mistakes in the past on the touchline. Yes, I will make less, but I think I will still make a few. What never happened to me and will never happen is to be suspended for match fixing. That never happened to me and will never happen.
Yesterday you said you were ready to fight for Chelsea, for your players and for yourself. So how do you respond to Jose Mourinho's comments last night?
But I think it's very difficult to answer this type of comment, because I think when a person the target is to offend, to insult another person, I think that you are a little man. And but I think that we all know him very well, also in the past. But he's always the same.
Does that worry you? Does it annoy you, the fact there's that lack of respect between managers?
No, but this is his way. This is not a surprise for me, but I repeat, when you insult, offend another person, it means that you are a little man, and I think that he's a little man.
Do you think that's the end of it now, or will it carry on, this to-ing and fro-ing?
No, but the life go on, and I'm not worried about him. But for sure, there is a good opportunity when we play against Manchester United to clarify in a room, me and him.
Why do you think he does it? What's behind it?
What?
Why does this happen? Why does he constantly make these remarks about you?
No, but I repeat, I don't know. I don't like to speak at the other coaches. And I think that when you tell something, you have to take the responsibility to tell this or this. If you try to speak and then to keep the situation in general. You must have a big personality and a big ball to tell this and this. And I'm talking about this. You understand?
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.